This video shows you how to get started using the DevExpress .NET MAUI Data Grid control to display data within a table. Before you begin, we recommend that you review our video on how to use our NuGet gallery to incorporate our controls into your new .NET MAUI application, or review the Get Started section in the documentation. For this video, we're also going to assume that you have the latest version of Visual Studio with all required workloads installed. If you're not familiar with the .NET MAUI framework, please review Microsoft documentation on how to start using this platform. Okay, let's get started. We're going to be using our sample application available on GitHub. In the Visual Studio Start screen, click on Clone a Repository. Specify the repository location. You can find a link to this repository in the description below. And click Clone. When the solution is downloaded, run it on your favorite device or emulator. Our .NET MAUI controls support both mobile platforms, Android and iOS. We'll be running this example on an Android emulator. This application consists of a single screen that displays a list of employees. Grid columns contain an image, contact name, job title, phone number, and other information from the bound data source. Now let's take a look at how this application is implemented, and then we'll make some additional customizations.
Take a look at the model.cs file.
It contains a data object represented by the employee class. This class exposes the name, photo, birth date, and other data properties. Photos are stored in the application resources. The employee data class in the model file stores sample data objects. The employee data view model class represents a view model for our main view. We'll bind our grid to the employees collection in the view model. Now let's open the main page markup file. At the top of the markup file, you can see the DXG XAML namespace that contains our data grid control. Then you can see that the binding context property is set to a view model instance. The page itself contains an instance of data grid view. It's bound to the employees property of the view model. Then we use the columns collection to specify grid columns. If we do not specify this collection, the control creates a column for each data field in the bound data source and uses a default data template to render data. In this example, we specify columns and data templates explicitly. As you can see, the first column is bound to the photo data field and uses an image object to render data. The second column displays data from multiple data fields in a single column. It uses multiple label objects to display text data. Below, you can see declarations for other columns, phone, birth date, and so on. These columns do not declare a custom data template. Now let's create yet another column that will display an employee's age. The bound data source does not contain this information, which means that we should calculate this data based on data in other columns. To do this, we should declare the column first. And then we use the custom unbound column data event to supply values for this column. In an event handler, we use the birth date data field to calculate the employee's age. Let's run the application. Now the grid displays a new column with calculated values. You can adjust the column width on the fly. Our grid control supports the hot reload feature. The next feature that we'll be using in this tutorial is grouping. Let's display users and administrators in different groups. All we need to do is enable the isGrouped option of the access data field. The control allows you to group items by data value or displayed value, by date, the exact date, month, quarter, or year, or group values alphabetically. In this example, we group rows by exact value in the access data field. Let's run the application again. As you can see now, all employees are divided into two groups, administrators and users. Let's add a group summary to know how many employees we have in each group. We use the group summaries property for this purpose and add a grid column summary instance to this collection. We then specify the column name and the summary type. Voila, the grid displays summaries in the group rows. You can also explore the data grid in our demo application. This application is available on App Store, Google Play, and GitHub. A link to the repository is available in the description below. Let's clone this repository and run the application. The first look demo shows almost the same list of employees, but the photo column is fixed. The virtual scrolling demo shows how fast our data grid is at rendering a large amount of data. If this feature is enabled, the grid processes only those rows and columns that are currently displayed in the viewport. Editing demo shows various data editors used to update values in the cells. You can edit values directly in the cells or enable a separate data form. And that's it for this video. You can download the application and explore other demos to see how they're implemented. If you liked this video, give us a thumbs up. If you have questions, please comment below. And don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell so you get notified anytime we release new content. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.